What's up, guys? It's Camo here, and welcome back to race 3 of the Tide Pro series. We are at New Hampshire. That's right, we are in New Hampshire for 30 laps of action. And the last episode, or sorry, not last episode, last race, some weird stuff went on, and it gray screened. I've never seen that before. It is really weird. So at the end of this one, I will go over and show you guys race 2. So there's that. So let's get into it. Eric Heiden starting on the pole. Next to him, Jay Durrell. Yep. Ryan Madden, James Richardson, Abe Troxel, Emerson Sheets, Cody Hagen, Tristan Allen, Oscar Lopez, Griffin Lynn, Sam McBride, John Gilbert, not Tristan, sorry, Thomas Troxel, excuse me. Ethan Harrison? Yes. Henry Williams, Mitchell Carter, Nathan Bell, Peyton Beasley, Matt Tuck, Eli Bright, Jacob Forbes, and Eric Monaco. That is your full field. So let's get started. So they should be pulling off. There we go. And Eric Heiden will get us going here at New Hampshire. Now, who is that? Give me a second. And we're going back. Whoops. I'm just going to fast forward a little bit. There we go. Coming back to the line, Eric Heiden is going to lead the field to the green. Okay, now that they're going by. Oh, who's blown an engine? That was Cody Hagen. Okay, back to the front. Eric Heiden. Hopefully, if someone has car problems this time, I'm done. They're just not making it. Okay. So hopefully everyone's fine. Hopefully. Okay, it looks like everyone is, and Eric Heiden is going to get us to the green for the third time in this one. Actually, he didn't even make it one other time. So that stinks. But we could have a caution very early in this one. Who knows? It's out 106, so take that however you want. I don't know how they're going to run here. I don't usually have my cars run here or have my series run here. So Take that how you wish. James Richardson looking for second. From what I'm seeing, it's not the easiest place to pass at, even though short tracks are usually fairly okay with the passing thing. So Eric Heiden, he's probably really enjoying this then, if it's going to happen like that. No, Martinsville. Yeah, it's a little bit easier to pass, I would say. You got Abe Troxel, Cody Hagen right there. Thomas Troxel, I believe. No, sorry, Ryan Madden. My bad. Emerson Sheets. Thomas Troxel is right here. This is Thomas Troxel. Oh, and it looks like we have a spin. That's the 56 of Ethan Harrison. Is that going to bring out the caution? Oh, there was actually a lot more to this. The 24 involved. 18 might have been involved. The 29 was definitely involved. I don't know who else was. The 2 was involved. So actually, let's just go back. We're going to take that off for now. Oscar Lopez. Heavy rear end damage there. This is interesting. Oh, the 29 went around. It was Sam McBride, and it looks like the 12 of Tristan Allen also got some damage there. He actually had some prior. Both of these drivers did. Unless it's a glitch, and yeah, I don't know if it's a glitch or not, but they already had some rear-end damage. I don't know what that was from. So I don't see any cars with front-end damage, so maybe it's a glitch or something. I don't know. It's something, but looks like they were going 3 wide, and ugh, it's very tough there. No, but that's not the spot. Oh, there it is. Right there, coming off of turn... What turn were we in? I believe that was like turn 2, something like that. Coming off of turn 2, Oscar Lopez and Tristan Allen and Sam McBride just kind of... Lopez and McBride, get into it here, right there. And 56, just a little bump. Not much, and the 29 getting into the 14 of John Gilbert. Ooh, the 78 was involved in this one. So was the 16 and the 18. And man, actually that 24 car got a pretty tough one. Oh, what in the world? Yeah, okay, that was a glitch, the rear end damage, but that's a tough one. Jacob Forbes involved. Let's watch this one in real time from Ethan Harrison's point right now. Let's just watch this, and there you go. So a lot of drivers involved, and that's got to be tough. I want to go on board with the 24 real quick before we get back to racing, just to just to see. You're just coming off the turn. You just assume everything's okay. I think you would assume that. There you go. I mean, you have time, but you just... That's unavoidable. He's fine. He's fine right here until the 29 gets into him. And then there goes the 78, and that's where the 2 got the rear end damage. So it's tough. But why does the 20... Or why does the 12 have rear end damage? I guess that was just a glitch. I don't know, but... Excuse me. That's really unfortunate for a few of these guys, as they're going to probably not continue. And especially need those points, as the chase is very, very, very close. Not as close as the SCSO, but it's pretty close. It's only like 2 races after the SCSO chase starts, so... there you go. Well, it looks like that was just enough. We're gonna get racing, or get back to racing on lap 8. I like this series, I really do. It's, like, when you ask me out of the favorite at the moment, it would probably be the Dollar General, and then the OTCS, or, well, the Old Timer Cup series, and then this series. But, like, the SCSO, it's fun, but I know it's the exact same thing as the TCS, but I don't know, I like the TCS a little bit more. It's, I don't know. Like, 10 cars, long races, I think I might change that in the future, where, like, the TCS is going to be more cars as it gets on. It'll probably max out at, like, 20 or 25 cars for the entire series. I want to say 20. Is what I want to max it out. I want to keep it small. I don't want to keep it too big, just because it's based off of the SCSO. So there you go. But I thought 10 cars was a little bit more boring. More cars the better, I think. And it looks like that caution was all Richardson needed. Oops. All Richardson needed was that caution, but I don't know if he's gonna get around Hayden, as we've seen Hayden making a really good run on the outside there. Is he going to clear him? Yeah, Richardson is now clear. But don't count him out yet. Here comes Abe Troxell in the three. No, fighting for third. I don't know if he's going to get it just yet. Nope, still battling with Jay Durrell. Durrell has been stuck up there for quite a bit of this one. Here comes Ryan Madden on the bottom here. Looks like Durrell is about to lose another spot. No. Is Madden not able to keep his nose under that 39 car? And he's going to fall into fifth. Oh, and we have a caution. My bad. I didn't realize. It looks like the 78 of Eric Monaco was involved in this one. Maybe just a single car spin. I don't know. Can't say that 2 is directly in there. Oh, they were going three wide. Eli Bright. Been at the back for this one. Yeah, Monaco just never got turned. And again, Eli Bright never gave them room to turn. It was very minimal, and that two being there just put them into the wall. That's a second one for the two. Man. Eric Monaco. First caution of the day. So, let's get going. Oh, goodness. So, yes, it... Are you kidding me? How? It's a small track. Small track. My bad. Eric Heiden leading, but what I was going to say was the SESO, it's probably the most interesting because every other series has the round of 16, the round of 12, 8, and then 4, I believe. Yes, that's what it is. And it's normal-ish because some only have one round of 16 or one round of everything, and some have two, or one has two rounds, and then the rest have the regular three rounds. But the SESO is quite different, as it really, like, every car is going to make it. So when we have our first chase race, there's going to be only four. So you'll have your round of 10, everyone's going to make it. The winners of the season, or the winners of the series, will have their like five bonus points or whatever, and then we get into the race of eight. So two cars will be eliminated every time, and it'll go on from there. So it'll go down from 10, 8, 6, and 4, and there you go. That round of 4 is going to be the last one, and whoever wins, or whoever is the points leader by the end of it, will have their, will have the championship. And wow. Abe Troxell trying to get around Richardson here. I don't know if he's going to be able to do it, but we'll just have to see. Richardson is fighting really hard on the outside to keep second, but seconds are an extremely hard spot to keep, and they're going to bounce off each other. They almost went three wide with Jay Durrell. And that might have just pushed them up the track enough to get into each other. Ooh, and Durrell's going to go wide up the track. Looks like Troxell's going to get second here. Yes, he will. James Richardson, is he going to fight back? Oh, no. We're nearing the end of this one. I think the 29 car with rear-end damage still. Sam McBride. Oscar... Dang it. Why did I wasn't even paying attention to that. Looks like we only have one car out of this one. That's 24. Jacob Forbes. Griffin Lynn. This is the first time he's been in the top five. Or, well, he's probably been in the top five for a while, but the first time I've really said his name all day. Same with Peyton Beasley. Some of these drivers you just haven't seen much. Like Mitchell Carter, the 18 of Nathan Bell, or Nate Bell, Henry Williams, John Gilbert. Looks like the 12 is okay. Tristan Allen, doesn't look like he got really hit or involved in anything. Now you do have this right side, but I mean that's really pretty much it. Yeah, Thomas Troxell. Emerson Sheets in here, and Matt Tuck in the 21 there. But at the moment, I don't know, Abe Troxell might be able to catch up, but really, this 48 has been dominant all day. And I mean, saying that we usually don't get winners from the pole is, well, it's quite true, just because we don't like racing on short tracks because dominant races or something. That's my biggest guess, and or guess, not guessed. So I don't know. Richardson looking pretty good today. Couldn't hold on to second from Abe Troxell, but that is a okay. A top three in this series is very good. Actually, top 5 is really good. Top 10 is pretty good, as there are 22 cars, but see, the only series where top 5 barely cuts it is the SCS over the TCS. It's just, I don't know. You can win a race, but it's not always going to help you. I mean, with there being 10 cars, it's quite easy for points to change and go everywhere, but it's not the easiest to keep them either, because the field isn't that big. Ethan Harrison falling back, actually, I want to know what's wrong with his car that the 29 can get around him. His car looks completely fine. So that's really weird to me. Sorry.
Oh, my chest.
Eric Heiden getting caught now by Abe Troxell. Let's see if Troxell can actually capitalize on him. Richardson tried earlier, but just could not complete it. Richardson is falling back. We got Cody Hagen here. And that 99 has really yet to move. From 5th, at least. You have Peyton Beasley just sitting in 6th. Now, he's going to have to make a last lap pass and get lucky with coming off of turn number 4. Seems a spot where it's not so easy. Or, well, passing on here, on this track, clearly isn't easy. But, yeah. Sorry, I blanked out there. Yeah, passing on here isn't easy. And trying to keep the lead is... Trying to keep your position is probably the easiest thing you can do here. And trying not to wreck, also pretty easy thing. Because they don't seem to, well, pass that often anymore. Oop! I stand corrected. Ryan Madden getting around Matt Tuck. Ooh, here comes Tristan Allen. Wow, that's a move. So, will we see a last lap pass from Abe Troxell, or is he too far away? I think we're going to have to see something here. Coming to the white flag, Eric Heiden has 2 turns to go. Abe Troxell, oh, he's going to go up high. I don't know if Troxel's actually going to catch him. And Troxell. Abe Troxell looks way too far. Eric Heiden entering turns 3 and 4. Coming off turns 3 and 4 now. Eric Heiden is going to win at New Hampshire. Congratulations to Eric Heiden on your win here today. Very dominant win here today. Shall I add, or may I add. Goodness. Oh, congratulations. There's your entire field there. Abe Troxell finishing 2nd. James Richardson 3rd. Cody Hagen 4th. Griffin Lynn 5th. Peyton Beasley 6th. Jay Durrell in 7th. Emerson Sheets in 8th. 9th of Thomas Troxell. And finishing 10th, Ryan Madden. Now at the bottom, Jacob Forbes was the only car not to finish, but some of these guys involved in that early wreck, like Oscar Lopez, Sam McBride. Actually, McBride made it around the 16 and the 56. I know the 16 did get into the wall, and that really kind of hurt him, but I don't know what was wrong with that 56. It was really, really bizarre, at least I think. Before I forget, I guess I better do this. What, TPS. Race 3. And with that, I want to thank you guys for watching, and I will see you at the points.